are live. That's it. We are live. Yep. What's going on, everyone?
Hello, everyone. We're live on Facebook. I'm just making an Instagram post.
I missed my chance. I guess that was it.
Welcome to episode one of Jump Street Podcast.
Welcome, everybody. Welcome.
My name is Billy O'Neill.
My name is Austin Pass. We are live from the slums of Shetland,
Staten Island, New York. And this is the first episode of our podcast. We wanted to make something where we could have guests, have a chat, kind of make a show where we could have people tuning in. And you can follow
Are you guys hearing us well out there? Let us know also if you're, we're new to this stuff too. So we want to make sure that we can, you guys can all hear us and everything. So just let us know in the comments.
Okay, so this is an interactive podcast. We have live chat on the show. You could ask questions. You can talk.
This is the whole point in this. We want everyone involved in this. So feel free to comment, ask questions throughout the show. You know, we're going to get to everybody here. And nice. Max said we're loud and clear.
Cool.
That's good. That's good. Awesome. That's good. Thank you, everybody, for joining us. I know it's like a weird little intro thing. We had a little street edit to go out and promote this. And hopefully it's good. If anything happens throughout the show, let us know so we could do our best to fix it. Cool.
Awesome. Also, you can follow us on Instagram at Jump Street Podcast.
Mm-hmm.
Facebook.com/Jump Street Podcast. Our YouTube channel.
It's not Jump Street Podcast.
It's not Jump Street Podcast.
You need 100 subscribers for us to change your name.
Okay.
So right now we have zero.
So now.
Yeah. Follow us. All our links are
in the...
Stay tuned for that one. It's up, but it's just not YouTube slash whatever. So we're up. Follow us. We're going to have Instagram. We're going to be doing like, you know, our own little skating stuff on there, a little BTS stuff like that. On our Facebook page is where we're going to be posting our live streams from now on. So I know this is on our personal pages right now, but the next episode and every other one are going to be on our Jump Street Facebook page. The next day or two, we're going to have the edits on YouTube. So you'll be able to watch like a fully edit. We have multi cameras here, but like I said, this is a learning process for us. We don't have the equipment to get everything live streaming. So the YouTube version will have the both angles. It'll look nice and pretty Hollywood shit.
Yeah.
We are also on SoundCloud for the audio. And we have a Patreon page down there, also linked below, if anybody feels like supporting. All of our money that we do get, if we do get any money, will go back into the podcast itself, whether it be merch, gear, making our equipment better, or whatever it may be. So please like, subscribe, follow, all that stuff below. And we're also curious about iTunes and Spotify. We don't have those accounts set up yet, but we're kind of hearing that you don't, like most people don't really use those anymore. I don't know. So if you guys use iTunes and Spotify for listening to podcasts, let us know. We'll make more of an effort to get those going soon as well.
Cool.
Yep.
All right. So welcome to the show. Let's get right into it. Some of you may know Austin. Some of you may not. Some of you may know me. Mm-hmm. Some of you may not. But I thought we'd start the show with... introducing ourselves, a little bit of history of who we are.
Yeah, definitely.
And kind of getting into that. So, Austin, how do we know each other? And
how do we know each other?
Let's give us a little bit of your background and what you do.
Yeah. How do we know each other? I guess through skating.
Right.
We've known each other for, I don't even know how many years we've known each other. At least like 15. I mean, because we definitely skated back in the day, but we might not have been like
15.
Friends or something like that.
Yeah,
we definitely been close like 15 years or something like that.
I'd say closer to 20. I'd probably assume knowing, but friends probably.
Yeah, yeah. We definitely been skating together for at least like 20 years or something like that. That's just how like the scene was back then.
Yeah.
Nowadays, it's probably like if you see a blader at the park, you're like, oh shit, let's be friends. You're like the only one left, you know?
It was so much
But it wasn't like that back then.
Exactly.
So, but I've been skating for like 22 years from Staten Island, New York, still in Staten Island, New York. Used to be sponsored, believe it or not. I used to ride for Valo, like Able Frames, Eulogy Wheels, Bunique. Almost forgot about Bunique back in the day. Aggressive Mall, Create Originals, all those good guys. And I don't know what else there is more to say about me besides, you know, don't skate professionally like that anymore, but we do it for fun all the time for the love, you know.
Okay.
That's how it is.
So that's your skating background, but what have you been up to lately, other like for your day-to-day, like in your daily life?
I guess more like obviously work now that we're adults. We've been working a lot. I've been doing a lot of like video and photo stuff. I have my own wedding cinema business that I do. I do like freelance stuff. Whatever it is, you know, that stuff all branched from skating also, which maybe we'll get into another episode, be it that. But trying to skate like once or twice a week, like with you, when my back's not hurt, whatever. It's good to have you back in New York too, by the way.
Thank you.
Welcome back to New York.
Thank you very much.
Proper introduction back to the Big Apple.
Thank you.
I know you're on the West Coast for a while. Maybe you could talk about that in a second. But yeah, like whatever we can, anytime we can to skate together and connect. We have a lot of things in common. We drum, we skate, we ride bikes, we do all that stuff. We eat pizza.
Right, eat pizza. We love pizza.
Yeah, we love pizza. All that good
Staten
stuff.
Staten Island guys.
Yeah, yeah. We'll bring some pizza to show you guys too in a few episodes.
We'll have to have some pizza episodes.
We'll have some pizza reviews.
Pizza review
Proper
episodes.
Pizza reviews, yeah.
Yeah, right.
I have a pizza highlight on my Instagram already, so we'll bring some in and we'll do some proper pizza reviews throughout the show. But yeah, what about you?
Okay, well, for me, my background was, you know, I grew up skating, right? Blading for those who, whatever, call it that. And so grew up skating in the city, then eventually got sponsored like by local skate shops and then flow for certain companies and then just worked my way up the ladder and, you know, became a pro at pro skates.
Did you ride for any skate shops back in the day?
You know, let me think.
Did you ride for a year and a day?
God, did I? I don't think I had any shop sponsors.
We used to have a year and a day.
I just said I did, and I didn't.
We used to have a shop, like, year and a day was called, like, our local Staten Island skate shop.
Yeah, I knew that one. I wish Franco skated for that.
Oh, he was on part of the home team?
Franco skated on the home team, the Sotos, but not me. Yeah, I always wanted
But go on. I was just curious, because, like, there was a lot of skate shops back in the day. It was a bigger thing, and now there's no skate shops.
Yeah, so whatever. We like, traveling pro skaters for a while. And then after that, or bladers. And then after that, you know, I kind of had some injuries. Mm-hmm. So I kind of got into, I was in California from skating. Mm-hmm. I got into work at, like, medical marijuana dispensaries, and then I worked for a company called Spliffin, and I was working with John Bellino there, and we were managing production. Mm-hmm. And I've decided to come back to New York. Yeah. And I've been working bike messaging and, you know, trying to skate and linking up with friends again and trying to skate and do all that.
Yeah, it's been good having you back, I'll tell
you. Thank you. It's been good being back.
As far as somebody having a schedule where I only work on weekends and no one to, like, be around during the week, like, it's good to have somebody with the same schedule.
It's been great being back, to be honest, just, like, seeing everyone. Like, New York has such its own unique vibe where just there's so many generations of people that are just still there and it's just such good vibes and everyone's like working so hard, so it's like it's really good to be back. You know,
everyone's working towards, like, there's still, like, so many skating things going on even in New York now, like with John and Ray and his stuff, and we got, like, all these contests going on and all that stuff.
We'll totally get into that later for sure, but there's so much happening. It's such a vibrant city,
right?
And I think that's why kind of the thing that made us, like, kind of want to create this podcast, I mean, this live stream, because we wanted to, like, make something interactive, like, make a platform and stuff like that. So I think that was, like, the cause behind us trying to do that.
And speaking of which, if you guys have anything you want to say, you know, drop it down in the comments. Any questions at all for us or what we're talking about or something you just want to say, you know, speak it, you know, write it down in the comments. At the end of the show, we're going to have, like, a more of a Q&A thing. We'll gather, like, a few questions that we'll answer. And we'll use some time at the end of the show to do that. So don't be shy. You know, speak it. Brandon Ford, what up? We have 47 viewers so far.
Oh, we have 47
viewers? Yeah, it's pretty good.
Okay, very cool.
Nice, nice. Also, if you want to share this with your friends while we're going live, let them know what's going on right now. Bill and Austin are on the air live.
Please share.
Please share. Jump Street, you know, it's where it's at.
Okay, cool. I think a lot of things on the show we want to do other than, you know, have guests on, interview people, and we kind of wanted to talk about current events. And one of the main current events that's kind of gripped the whole skating world is Rob G and what's been going on with him. So getting directly into that, we wanted to give updates to everyone who might not know. For all those who don't know, get your updates solely and only from his GoFundMe page. Yeah. It's GoFundMe.com/Robert Guerrero, or you can go to Google GoFundMe and Robert Guerrero.
It's at 123. I just checked right now.
Okay,
it's
at $123,000.
It's not enough, though. We need more.
It's not enough.
We
need
more
for
Rob.
He has a high list of medical expenses, and we got to do everything we can. He is a rollerblading treasure. He is a treasure to the human species. Mm-hmm. He's just one of the greatest guys. And so, please, if you guys have the time, please take a look at that GoFundMe page and always check there for updates. But for those who haven't checked on that GoFundMe page, I've written down a few updates that his family and his sister has been gracious enough to give us. Mm-hmm. And so, you know, Robert was, for those of you who don't know, Robert was shot in the head in Peru. And he was, in the middle of the jungle during a ceremony. And so he's back in the States now. It's been a long process to get him back. He's finally back. And one of the updates is he's began his first rounds of physical therapy. He's sitting upright in his chair and eating lunch, which is just incredible.
Even hearing, like, the other day when he was speaking alone, like, that he could remember his transportation from Peru to San Francisco. Yeah. That's crazy. It's like, to hear anything insane. Like that. I didn't expect to hear anything like that for a while.
Yeah, all these things are so uplifting to hear.
Mm-hmm.
And, that also, he's also beginning to walk a few steps with
assistance.
That's
crazy, too. Yeah.
But it's just massive that he's, you know, I think everyone who's ever met Rob can just say that he's just like one of the most glowing, pure energies. He's mm-hmm. a very honest person. And
it's crazy that, like, you always hear, like, oh, he's like the best person ever. He's such a good guy or such a human being. But, like, Rob G, like, really was, like, he anybody who is. Like met him, which obviously, like, a lot of people have. And he's, like, he's definitely one of a kind, definitely unique, and he really is a good guy. Like, you meet one of us, and we could be, like, assholes or something like that, but not Rob G.
It's true. Like, he's really, like, one in a billion.
Yeah.
But from considering what happened, he's been doing incredible. The doctors are saying mm-hmm. he's doing really good things. And I think, you know, you could attribute a lot of it to, like, you know, not only who he is as a loving spirit, but, you know, just the love that, you know, he shared coming back to him, like the mm-hmm. good vibes and just the spirit. So I don't know. It's pretty incredible what's happening mm-hmm. with him.
Yeah. Every day is just better and better news. And it's like, every time it's like, holy shit. Like, it's can't really believe that. Like, yeah, exactly. Yeah. It's crazy. He's Superman, yo.
It's crazy. He's got an incredible road ahead. No, but he,
yeah, I definitely, mean, but still, but considering, I mean, the circumstances,
it's something that's one of the best things that could be happening, and that we just wanted to talk about, you know, like show some of Rob G skating.
Yeah,
and
we have it in the background here, his like rollerblade editor, something like that. But I just saw this for the first time. I don't know if you ever seen this.
Oh, coming up is like Rob's signature trick right here. Oh,
he's done a bunch of them. He destroys that blue curve ledge.
That and the TTP.
Yeah,
like
the TTP.
Fully Rob's thing.
I always try to do that TTP and I can never do it. I remember like a Montreal Classic one year on that, you know, that down ledge, that double down ledge. I tried doing that. I'm like, I can't do it. It seems so easy. And then he went like full cab first try. And I was like, geez. I'm like, I'm done. I'm never doing that again.
That's so Rob. He was probably just like laughing about it.
It was like when he first like started doing those a lot too. And I was like, geez.
Wow.
Classic.
It's funny, like, so you were talking about earlier that, like, the things he did on Hubba's Hideout, like the true front torque.
Yeah, because Miguel just posted, like, a clip of him. Yeah, the true front torque both ways. And that's, like, not even new. That's, like, what, like, 15 years old, like, 12 years old, something like that.
It's incredible. Like, although he was, like, even then, like, so far beyond.
Yeah.
Like, I remember even at, do you remember the Detroit IMYTA, like, the first one with that really steep rail?
Yeah.
That was like, I feel like everyone knew that Rob G was so sick, but like that one is when like we're like, yo, Rob has arrived.
Yeah. People went nuts on that one.
Yeah, like that.
And that spot's no joke too.
Like I think before that, like only like a couple people were balancing the fast slide.
Exactly,
it was like DL and mm-hmm. Farmer
or
something like that.
Yeah, like Feinberg maybe.
Maybe Feinberg, but like it was like DL and Farmer, and then like Rob did it on that rail, and it was just like.
Yeah.
It was like in like the best setting too. Those IMYTAs
of course,
have
yeah,
like
those vibes
thousands
are the best.
Of people, like, you know, and it just like if you wanted, they just like you got engulfed into mm-hmm. like a sea of people. And,
damn, those like that's. I was watching when I was making the intro. Whoever saw the intro, there was like clips of old IMYTAs in there. So I had to like watch like one or two videos to like try to find like the best clips to use, and like the vibes that were going off. Then I was like. One, it was just like so sick just to watch, but like just to remember being there for those times, it was like unreal.
Yeah.
Like the hype, like you really don't get that. Like John Julio, like described it in one of like the first video, whatever. It's like you truly have to like be here to experience like the whole thing, and you kind of do. And it's like the
especially
vibe is crazy.
Ones,
yeah. When people are just wilding out, there was no rules, there was no permits, nothing like that. Just straight like guerrilla style, going from spot to spot. You get kicked out, like all right, fuck you, cops. Like gone
oh
to the next
God.
One.
Those first few were super special.
And even the first one at the Hyatt Rail,
My God, that one was like one of the best ones.
There's a clip of like Zeke talking to someone, and he's like, "All right, so we're gonna get kicked out of this place 100%. But what are you gonna do? You're gonna put your foot in front of the door so the security guards can't get out, and we're just gonna go run this rail."
Yeah.
And I was like, "Dang, that's fucking nuts."
It was the most thugged out thing.
So sick.
If I'm not mistaken, that was happening before anyone else was doing street comms.
Yeah, I guess.
I think from what I heard, this might be wrong. We'll have to. You know, down the line when we get Julio on as a guest mm-hmm. or whoever else on. But I heard that during the first IMYTA, I think it was like Chad Muska came up because across the street they were having the X Games, you know?
Oh, yeah. And it was one
of the first years that rollerblading wasn't in the X Games. Mm. So this was like the kind of...
Oh, yeah, yeah. All this history is coming back.
It all ties in, right?
I gotcha.
So
what happened with Chad?
So they kind of set this up in to as a response to that. And I guess Chad Muska, there were so many rollerbladers, thousands, mm-hmm. you know? And I guess Chad Muska showed up and he was like, "What is this?" And mm-hmm. they were like, "Oh, it's a rollerblading event." He was like, "Wow." And then, you know.
But he hates bladers, right? He's like one of the guys that hates bladers.
Yeah, I don't think he does. I don't think he likes bladers, but whatever. But I think he, you know, he saw that. And then, you know, down the line, whether it was created, I think skateboarding events came too. As an example.
They have their street. I know it's not like a real street comp, but they have their street league and stuff like that or whatever it is. But. Yeah, if IMYTA really was one of those first true street contests,
I think it really was before BMX, before skateboarding.
Yeah, that's
It's funny because the New York invite, the one that we did under the bridge in Brooklyn, Adidas started doing skateboard comps
at that spot. They build ramps and shit.
They build ramps.
Jeez,
they do it at the exact same spot.
Has Adidas written you any royalty checks for that?
No.
Have you seen the contest? Are they like?
Ray sent me a link to it. Yeah, so it's pretty interesting.
And you got no credit for those.
Well, no, we didn't get credit for it. No, but we definitely thought of the idea, but we didn't own the idea.
Yeah.
You know, it's like a pizza.
Of course not. But
if someone invents
the
making
same
a pizza,
spot, come on, how are you gonna do that?
I know.
You couldn't pick any spot in New York. You picked the same spot that we used to have.
It's crazy, man. It was those IMYTAs were really special. Those street comps were really something.
Have you ever laced in any of those? I mean you competed in a few. Did you ever make it the finals or anything like that?
Yeah, I got to the finals in one in Amsterdam years ago. Mm-hmm. It was the one that Nick Lomax won.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah, and I got to the finals in that.
Was that the drop rail in the finals?
Yeah, and then I tried to 360 topsail the drop when I fell from the top to my heel.
Oof. I did the same thing.
And then
thing
I just bruised my heel and I couldn't walk and I was like, damn.
That was your ender?
That was my ender.
I've never bruised my heel ever in my life. And then in Dubai a few years ago, of course, I don't skate.
Just a few years
rails.
Ago?
Yeah, I never bruised my heels ever. And wow. I did the same exact thing. Tried a three topsail, a king drop rail, and I just 360'd over the whole rail. I missed my soles, everything. Just straight 360 over, straight to flat bottom, no speed, and ruined my heel for the next week, which sucked because I went to Australia after that too. So it was fucked up for most of that trip too. Yeah, it sucked.
That is the worst.
Yeah. But that's funny. I never bruised my heel until that.
Yeah. Bruising heels is the worst thing you could ever
It sucks.
Have.
It's you don't think that it'll really cripple you that much.
Yeah.
But literally every vibration of the rocks and the ground and everything,
you can't do anything.
Feel it. Yeah, it sucks.
And then you're walking around on your tippy toes work the next day.
And you get
shin splints. And then all your workers are what the heck is wrong with this guy?
You're limping around and shit.
Yeah. It's so funny. Well, also, the Bashi Pope skate off.
Yeah, speaking of contests.
August 26th. Speaking of contests.
The Pope off.
The Pope off. The BPSO.
The BPSO.
You know what I'm saying? Silk City. Bro, it ain't a joke.
So, this is the third year?
This is the third year.
Yeah.
Yeah. We got a ton of people coming into town for it.
Who's coming? Tell us.
Well, the guys from Them
Spit
Skates
it.
Are coming.
Okay.
Robbie Pitts.
Rob Pitts, okay.
Sean Darst. John
Julio, the president.
Yep, the president.
The president.
Chris Farmer's coming in.
Julio should really roll up to a comp in a convoy of black
cars. Like a bulletproof limousine.
Like an actual president.
But instead of the American flag, there's little Them Skates
flags. Yeah, the little blue balls just following him.
And we'll just get Secret Service, Derek Henderson in a suit.
Just the biggest guys in the business.
Just Derek Henderson and Miguel in suits, just buffed up with sunglass Ray-Bans on.
I like that.
And they just
we'll make that happen. You know how they always do stupid shit at Winter Clash? They should do one of those.
Yeah.
Have people dress
That'd
up like Farmer and Arlo and stuff.
That'd be good.
All right, go on though. Who else is coming?
Okay, so Chris Farmer. Montre's coming. Montre has come every year.
Mm-hmm.
John Cooley's coming.
Mm-hmm.
So Ichiro is making the trip.
That's crazy.
From Japan. He's come with some friends, too.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
Everyone loves watching those guys, too. Has he ever been to a Bashi Pope thing? Do you remember? I only been to one last year.
You know, I feel like, no, because I feel like if he, I feel like I saw him at the first one.
Because usually you remember shit that he does.
Right? Like he, maybe, yeah. Maybe he came to the first one, but he didn't skate.
He definitely wasn't there last year, I know, because.
I know a lot of, formerly of Valo guys came to the first one.
Yeah. I remember, like, Brandon was, like, B. Smith right. was there and shit, and Yvonne and Victor.
Yeah.
But, yeah, I don't remember Soshiro. He definitely leaves a mark, though, so he would probably remember if he was there or not.
Yeah, he'd probably be in the top three.
Yeah, always does. There. Yeah.
Yeah.
And I'm happy that I just found out, like, 2 days ago or something like that, that I'm actually, I thought I was working that day, which I was like, fuck, that sucks, but I'm actually going to be there, which is huge now. I know I told a lot of people I wasn't going to be there, but.
Yeah, because you thought it was a Saturday, because, yeah, most, yeah, I thought, traditionally most comps
I'm glad
are.
It's on a Sunday. Yeah.
But last year went off.
Yeah. It usually always does. It's like, that's like a whole nother thing, too. It's like a different vibe than going to another contest, like in Cali or wherever it may be or whatever it is, because
you get that
New York City summer vibe. You get all the stenches. You're under like the bridge. You got all the bird shit on you.
You get all the good smell. The thick humidity.
You think you're a good skater, then you come to like New York and you skate in New York Park, and you're like, oh, wait a minute.
Wait, this is disgusting.
The floor is slippery. There's like gum everywhere.
It's humid. It's
more people rolling blunts than skating usually.
Yeah, there's like a ton of like beers around.
Yeah.
It's great.
It's way different than anything else.
Oh, it's lovely.
If you haven't made it to a Bashi Pope, oh, Miguel, you forgot to mention Miguel's coming.
Which.
To the Bashi Pope thing.
Miguel's coming to the Bashi Pope?
Yeah. No?
Which? I'm sorry.
What do you mean, which?
Is Miguel coming? Oh, that's right. Miguel is coming.
Yeah. Abdiel just said.
I thought you said Miguel's comment.
Oh, no. Oh, Miguel's coming. Yeah.
No, Miguel's coming to the Bashi Pope. Anyone who's been... Miguel is like... In the Rob G category of human.
Definitely. Know, he's another guy where, like, it took me years to meet him finally, and I met him, and you could tell he's, like, he's just a huge, like, gentle giant.
Yeah, he's
like,
just a ball of energy. Yeah. Like, a glowing light human being.
Oh, I gotta reset the cameras real quick.
But it's, he's just, like, he's just, like, one of the greatest guys. So, I guess...
Of course.
You gotta...
I gotta reset the cameras.
Gonna reset the cameras.
This is guerrilla style, so I gotta reset the cameras. Hang on real quick.
Yeah, at the current moment, we don't have a staff. Austin's running it with three of his own cameras. And, you know, at the current moment, we don't have any staff. We're gonna change that. But for now, we gotta reset the cameras while we keep the live stream going. Yeah, but like I said, Miguel's coming. It's gonna be amazing. Miguel just actually came back to skating. He was off for a long time. He actually had, like, crazy back surgery, and, he had to get, like, screws in his back, and he had, like, these vertebrae problems, and he was out and couldn't skate for a long time, you know? He just in horrible pain and couldn't do what he loved, because I think everyone who knows Miguel knows how much he loves rollerblading.
Yeah, that was, like, heartbreaking for everyone to hear that, and that's, like, always scares me, too, because now a lot of people are having back problems that...
All kinds of problems are starting.
All kinds of problems, but back specifically because, I don't know, it's just happening now. Like, Justin had his, like, herniated disc he had surgery for, and Miguel's doing that. Someone before Justin, too, had the same problem. I can't remember who offhand.
Just, like, jumping stairs and falling on your back for
or anything.
Time.
Like, just, falling, like, doing a stair rail and hitting the stair on the way down. Like, that can't be good for you at all.
Just when you get older, I think you just got to take those extra steps to, like, you know.
You got
to
Miguel knows.
Miguel doesn't go anywhere without his foam roller.
Yeah.
You know, like,
I know a lot of people that don't travel with that as foam roller.
After 30, that's it.
I had to move mine, but yeah.
After 30, if you want to, like, skate or do anything, you need your foam roller.
Damn, see, I was good until last year, but now I'm 30, so now I got to.
That's it.
That's it. You hit the mark.
On your 30. If you know anyone who's 29 and about to be 30 who skates, that's a great birthday gift. It's a good gift. Not a specifically great stocking stuffer, but it's a good gift.
No, they're the best, though. Yeah, the foam rollers.
So, yeah, that's the Bashi Pope skate-off. And anyone,
hope to see everyone there.
And it was in the tri-state area. Come down August 26th.
Definitely. And we might be doing something. We're going to figure it out. We're trying to do something with that, too, with our show. But
we're
not 100% yet.
We're trying to figure out the logistics of how we can get Jump Street down. We're definitely going to have some
sort of live thing going on down there, because there's going to be so many people around, and we know for the people who aren't going to be there, it'd be nice to, like, get people to interact and maybe ask, like, a few questions about the contest with people who are there, like, while it's actually happening.
Yep.
So we're going to try to do that too. Also, if you haven't already, like us on Instagram, Facebook page, YouTube, what else? SoundCloud, Patreon, do all that stuff, like it, and be a part of the community as well.
Beautiful. Awesome. So now we're going to jump to this week's WTF of the week. The what?
Is this coming?
The WTF of the week. It's the what the fuck of the week. Every week we're gonna have a what the fuck of the week. And so this week's what the fuck of the week is from Theo from Stockholm. It's a courtesy of Unusual Blading at Unusual Blading on Instagram.
I don't know if you guys can see it on the live stream. We will have it on like the YouTube version and stuff.
But yeah, you'll be able to see this. If you can't see this on the live stream, you will certainly be able to see it. But it's a fakie to backflop.
Well, it's probably the worst fakie to backflop you've ever seen.
So he goes off the step here.
Yeah, first of all, he's trying to fakie backflip a stair, one stair.
Yeah.
Not multiple stairs, not a ramp, a stair.
So that's the first mistake. And it seems like he wanted to do the fakie backflip, and then like right before he jumped, he's like, I don't want to do it anymore.
And then that's everything. Like the whiplash, he probably hit his head. Like his tailbone is done. Oh, geez.
It's just like, if you could ask a question, what's the most you can get hurt on this one stair? This is probably the answer to that question.
That's true. I could post the link in the live chat. Maybe.
Oh, can you?
People could watch it like that.
Okay, well, we're posting the link in the live chat. If you can't see it.
Please enjoy this clip with us.
But this is the what the fuck of the week, ladies and gentlemen.
We might have like an intro song for the what the fuck of the week eventually. Who knows?
You know what? We're going to actually have to eventually have an intro.
We're stupid like boing.
For the what the fuck of the week.
Yeah, yeah. I'm with that.
But okay, that's it. And
moving on.
Also, before we continue this show, we're going to give a quick shout out to our sponsors. If you're in Boston and you're moving, go to Moving Forward in Boston, Massachusetts. MoveMeForward.com. Everything you need for your moving needs. You got a 2-man, 3-man, you get a 6-man crew. Anything from a studio apartment to a 8-bedroom house. Anything from your business office down to, you know, you got to move out of your sister's storage garage. Anything you got to do.
Grandma needs help moving, you know.
Great rates, great movers, quality service. Moving Forward, Boston, Massachusetts. And that's at movemeforward.com. Go check them out.
I like the comments so far. Miguel Ibanez says that's how you get back problems. If I were talking about it,
that is certainly
Jason Staines would get him a foam roller ASAP.
That is certainly how you get back problems.
That is definitely good. See, that's why I like this interactive shit.
Yeah,
people throw their comments in there. That's perfect. And just to keep in mind, also we're gonna have open questions as well. So if anyone has anything to say or comment or whatever it may be, drop it down below, and we're gonna get to them by the end of the show.
Cool.
Do you want to talk about our little edit that we put out?
Yeah.
Is that on the thing?
We could talk about
it. So, guys, we skated street.
Yeah,
we skated street. We skated street. If you guys didn't see, we had a little, like, 1 minute, like, a minute and a half little edit that we put up. It was, like 3 days skating, something like that?
Three sessions, three days of skating.
One of them was, like, a half one, like, at night.
We didn't leave Staten Island.
Yeah, there's one clip of me in the city, but that was from another session that was before we actually decided to make a street.
Which club? The
Rolls of Soul on the fountain marble ledges downtown.
That's right.
I don't count that though as part of the sessions. That was just like a clip that I randomly had before,
but it was mainly a Staten Island
Staten Island. It was cool. We kept it like close to home, like how we grew up skating for the most part.
Yeah,
visited some old spots that we used to skate like fucking like 15-20 years ago. Got to look at them with new eyes and skate them in a different way.
It was tough for me, I'll be honest, because I haven't really skated street in like forever.
Yeah,
like
likewise.
You know, like nowadays when I skate, you know, because you know I'm in my 30s, mm-hmm. and I'm just like, well, you know, I guess I'll skate the mini ramp.
It's so easy. I mean,
I had the mini right by my house.
It's so easy now, we'll skate
the skate park.
You don't have to worry about like where are we gonna go today, if we get kicked out, what's next on the list.
Yeah, you know, so this is kind of what I transitioned to. Mm-hmm.
Of course, and, like a natural progression for like older
people, right? But I don't know, like since we decided to do this podcast, also I was like, oh, why don't we do a little edit, you know, street edit. And I was like, okay, cool. It sounds like a good idea. But, you know, when you don't jump on like a rail for a long time.
Did we skate all rails in the edit too? Except for like that weird red thing. Oh, I skated that bench once.
By the way, if anyone has seen that edit and they could tell us what that red thing we were skating was, it would be greatly appreciated.
Bonus question. If anyone knows what that red thing was on the pier.
That's in like a ferry Staten Island Ferry shipyard-ish dock area. Yeah. So it's like something...
New spot.
Maybe any naval people or any boatsmen.
Yeah, boatsmen.
Any boatsmen.
Is that a word?
Yachtsmen.
Seamen.
Seamen. Yeah. But, so yeah.
Yeah, but like skating, when was the last time you really skated like a down rail or something like that? You fucking skated a drop down rail that was like rib height. You had to jump over another rail too. And that rail we grew up skating like...
Yeah.
I went... That was my intermediate school. I went there for like... No, you didn't go there. You went somewhere else.
No, I didn't.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But whatever. I went to school there. It was like old school spot.
Yeah.
That was like... The rail that was in the middle next to the drop rail back in the day was like chopped in half. Like how there's two levels. It was chopped in half. And it was like a really low, like knee-high rail. Yeah. And that was perfect for me because I was like 8 or 9 years old. So it was like my waist height.
I could do this.
And I was like, woo, I can do it. And I started throwing myself doing souls and like royals and men. I don't know if I actually finished it because it might have been too long. But I definitely remember being happy about that. And it was cool to skate those spots you know, over again.
It felt like kind of going back in a time machine because we've been doing that for like ever.
Yeah.
Like how long? Like just either you and I or you, me and Franco and Joey.
Yeah.
Just like skating like and then, you know, passing the camera or back and forth.
Exactly. That's another thing.
It's got a good feeling to it. Like it's been happening for
Well, it's like bittersweet. It's like when you think about street skating, you're like, oh, it's work. I got to skate.
It's tough.
That's what we used to doing that for so many years. Like when
getting clips is the tough thing.
But when you think about street skating, that's what you think about now. So like when you want to go skate street, you're just like, oh, what can I get a clip on or whatever it is. And that's like the mentality I think that we're stuck with.
Yeah.
So we're like, oh, it's like almost like work going to skate street spots and shit.
Yeah.
But it was fun. Like, I guess not doing it for a few years. It was fun just to do like that. You said the handoff, the camera back and forth.
Yeah.
We took it a step further. We had a night session. That's a step further.
That's cool.
That's like digging in deep. We were in the streets, and then we're like, let's dig in deep and get the night session going. It was cool skating at night, though, especially in like the summer when it's like hotter in the daytime
I prefer that. Like,
it's cool. I have the lights too, and it works out.
Yeah. Like, for me, if I'm going to skate like street or park or whatever, I don't want to have anyone see me at this age.
Mm-hmm.
I want to be alone.
Yeah.
Like, you know, so like when I would skate the park, I'd go really early before like the little kids go.
Yeah, that's like the best time to do it.
Right. Or like streets the same thing. Like I'd like to skate at night. Like you know what I mean?
When
no one's there. Yeah. And you know,
and those spots we skated too, like
in the summer too, especially.
Yeah, like that the ender clip that you got, like it's a courthouse or whatever. You can't skate that during the daytime. There's cops with guns every fucking 5 feet, you know?
Exactly.
So that's like another plus of skating that. But I like having the light. We should do that more often because I have the light. So even like skate parks and stuff that like close, or there's no light at any skate parks in New York except for like two. But like if you bring the lights, we could skate even a skate park at night.
Yeah.
It'd be cool to do.
That would be cool.
Little solo session, like light up one of the ledges or something like that.
That would be really cool. I like doing that. Like the night sessions in the summer is like with the lights is really key.
We should do more of those.
Yeah, you die during the day.
Speaking of back injuries, my back is fucked up too. So once my back gets better, we'll do that too.
What happened with your back?
It's not even a skating thing. I was like shaving one morning over the sink, leaning over, and like first I got stretched before you shave, you know, from now on. So I was like leaning over the sink.
New stuff.
Like I just woke up. We had like a thing to do, like a shoot to do. I'm like, oh shit. Didn't want to get any hair on me because I had to like get dressed right afterwards. And like, I was like, oh my back. And now it's been like probably like a week and I'm like almost like 90% there. But like, you don't even got to be old skating and shit to get hurt anymore. Just do whatever.
It's just like, just living.
It was probably
enough to have a back injury.
It's probably all like the impact for me jumping those street sessions that like made me brittle and weak.
Yeah,
and then that was just like, that was like it.
It's like,
it was like 2 days after the last day we skated. And
yeah,
it was like 2 or 3 days, something like that. So I was still like healing, I guess, whatever.
Yeah. Body's weird when you get older. It just starts getting all temperamental.
But Carlos is showing us mad love. Pianowski.
Oh, Carlos Pianowski. Big shout out to Carlos Pianowski. I met Carlos a long time ago.
He's been skating too. Like I think he posted clips like a few weeks ago.
Yeah, he posted a clip with like a, what was it, like a circular saw, like a machine circular saw.
I don't
think
I saw that one. It sounds like Carlos.
Can you pull it up? Can you put up on Instagram?
Maybe it's on Instagram.
It's on his Instagram.
What's his Instagram name?
It's a Carlos Pianowski, I think. This is worth watching. He literally like royale, like it's a machine. Saw like,
and he skates it. Oh my god!
And there's two rails. There's two rails. Like right.
This is. I didn't even see the clip yet, but it seems so Carlos-y.
Can you throw it up?
Yeah, I'm gonna throw it up.
Sick. So yeah, essentially it's this.
Yeah. Anyway, I don't know if you guys can see it or not.
That could kill you.
What the fuck? All right, I take back our what the fuck clip of the week and okay. replace it with Carlos.
Okay, our new WTF of the week
is Carlos skating a rail next to a saw. How do I mute on this? All right, Carlos, keep it coming.
All right, so that's Carlos. Shout out to Carlos. Carlos. Shout out to Carlos Pianowski. Speaking of shout outs, going to give Jordan Baez a shout out. Just this past weekend, July 28th, he had his annual competition, the 12th and D Classic. He puts it on every year, as well as throws a bunch of other events throughout New York City. He runs Ghetto Community, a clothing company, and he just he works with Butter TV, JP Premiano. And yeah, he's been doing a lot for the city. And shout out to the winner of that competition, Anthony Marasa. Is that it? Marasa. I hope that's, I'm saying it right. I'm reading it.
It's good enough.
So shout out to Anthony M.
So, yeah, so there's still like a lot of events going on in New York.
Yeah.
I know that the Ray and John at Go Sports did like some event at Rockaway Beach the other day. They had like, like a 5K or 10K skate or something like that. Then people got up and I was going to go to that, but that was the day after I hurt my back. So I was like, I can't do shit.
Yeah. Go Sports is doing like, that's another shout out. Like they're doing like so much in the city. They're just like working with the Department of Education.
Yeah.
They're getting kids on skates. They got 800 kids a week, rollerblading in schools around the city. And right now they're working on trying to get it like as a as an accredited physical education class in schools. So they're really like pushing, like getting people. They worked with Mark Messier with
Crazy. They're doing shit.
And it's funny, like Mark Messier reached out to them trying to like get the skate programs going on in New York City schools.
That's so sick.
I just want to shout out everyone at Go Sports who's
That's Ray Mendez and John Ortiz.
It's Ray Mendez and John Ortiz
old
company,
New York skaters.
But it's like also shout out to everyone who works for them. Jesus Medina, Paulie Cortez,
Abdiel.
Steve Cortez, Abdiel Kohlberg, Pablo Munoz. I don't know. How do you say that? I'm a white guy. Munoz?
Munoz or Munzo?
Okay. So, yeah.
I'm dyslexic, so.
Yeah. So shout out to those guys and everything that they're doing.
So real quick, Matthew Rice is like, yo, is Billy back in New York now? And do you want to like talk about a little bit like your, what are you doing back here? Because you were in LA for a little bit.
Yeah, no. Okay, so I went to LA. I went there actually with a couple guys I was playing music with. And we moved there to kind of meet up with John Bellino and like do music stuff. And
we started in NorCal though, right? You didn't go straight to LA.
We had a band in NorCal, but then I moved back East Coast. Remember, I was living in
the
Bronx.
Oh, that's when you were in Jersey? Oh, the Bronx?
The Bronx.
So when Jersey was before that?
Jersey was after the Bronx. So I moved to the Bronx. And then I moved to, Newark. And then I was playing over there and in the city. And then we came to LA. And then when we went to LA, the kid who I was playing music with, he met a girl. I shortly after met a girl who I fell in love with. My girlfriend of 3.5 years now. And so I stayed in L.A. and then moved to Long Beach. And I've been in Long Beach for over 2 years.
That's it? 2 years?
Yeah, two years.
Longer than that.
Yeah, well, Long Beach. But I was in L.A. for like
a year and a half. Were you like downtown-ish? Like downtown. Arthur Sugar or something
We were living by Skid Row.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, so I was living with like John and...
Oh, nice.
Yeah, well, no, it was like the artsy district. It wasn't like in Skid Row, but by. You know what I mean? So it wasn't bad. But it wasn't great either. But
how close are you actually to Skid Row?
Well, Skid Row is massive. It's like downtown.
I've driven through it one time, but I never, in proximity to other shit, like where it is.
We were like on the outskirts of it. But LA has such a homeless people problem.
Just in general.
That there's like it's just like trails of it linger.
Yeah.
From the nucleus, you know?
Yeah.
But like downtown is like the nucleus of it. And we're not in that by any means, but we were just outside of it where you would see like the rustlings of you know, of that.
Yeah.
But yeah, so whatever. Then I just ended up having like, you know, I came here to work last summer, made good money. I came back to work again this summer and things were like the band were falling apart. And then I was just like, yeah, you know, might as well go to New York and take a good job. So I came to New York, take a good job, met up with old friends and everything, you know,
It feels good to be
it's
back.
It's the thing that when you're, no offense to California, but when you're like a New Yorker who's over there, like when you're like, there's something missing, you mm-hmm. know? And then like you come
there
back.
There definitely is, because I felt that also when I lived in yeah. Phoenix for a little bit. I know.
And
Adam,
it's no offense
to
California. No, it's just different. Like when you're from here.
It's just different.
I would imagine.
I'm sure they would say the same thing if they moved to New York.
I would imagine.
But no one does that. Who does that anyway?
It happens. Like, I'd imagine you'd feel the same way. You come from LA to New York, and yeah. like, I've heard it. Like, people like,
I'm trying to think of
where's
like
the good tacos? Where's the good food?
Oh, yeah.
Where's
no
the,
tacos.
You know, the,
it's like I was trying to find pizza.
The cool things of that, you know, California offers that you get used to. So I just got used to the New York way, and and being back, yeah, we're transitioning, moving back. We're moving to Queens. So it's going
to
be
nice.
Cool.
Good to hear. We're going to have you back in the New York scene.
I'm very excited.
I was like, how do we get Abdiel before we got Fish? It's crazy. Now we got you both.
How did we get
Abdiel? Now we got you both.
That's it.
We had to import it from Puerto Rico, and now, oh, you were just in LA.
It's perfect. I wonder if the audience is it lagging, or is this pretty on?
Yeah, let us know if like we're still sounding good out there. We're looking good out there.
Well, because
we're looking good in here.
Obviously, we're looking
good.
Yeah,
we're looking good in here. Oh, no, I know Max is in Florida now.
Okay.
Yeah, I guess when you move from like New York to anywhere outside,
it's tough.
Huge difference.
It's a tough transition.
And it feels like really nice at first, but you always come back to missing it. I'm sure like you feel that anywhere, kind of like home is always home.
Yeah.
New York has like a larger impact on that, though.
Totally.
And it's
I mean, you just get used to certain things, mm-hmm. you know, food is open longer.
Yeah, like, shit is open later. It's easily accessible.
Yeah, it's just you get kind of spoiled by certain things.
Nice. Okay, so we're sounding good right now.
Okay, good.
I remember like when I moved back from Phoenix back to New York, like a day or two after I moved back, I went to the supermarket to get like food or whatever. And I'm like waiting on line. There's like a customer in front of me, like taking forever, whatever it is. And then I'm not paying attention really. So I go to the cashier, whatever, like when it's my turn. And the cashier like looks at the person, looks back at me and goes, fucking asshole. And like it was like the day or two after I moved back, and I was I fucking missed that. Like
yes.
So like you don't really see that anywhere else, you know? I was like, that was the moment that I was like, oh, it just it hit me, like, oh, it's good to be back.
And now you and that guy are brothers for
life.
Yeah,
and now like we're
you're
Instagram
just like,
friends and shit. Yeah. See him all the time.
This guy.
That's how it is, you know, like you're not scared to like to do shit, whatever.
No, it's a good energy. It's good. It's good to be back.
That's
in that energy.
The energy.
Yeah, like I think both energies are good for different reasons. Like the California energy is like very, very relaxed, and it's there's something really appealing about that.
And when you grow up that way,
well,
I still think
it's appealing too. Like being from here, like
it's
I don't know, appealing,
but like it's kind of like since it's like a slower pace, I guess you get like tired of it quicker, you know. But like when you're accustomed to that, it's like this is life, this is what it is.
Yeah,
life is out of five right now, but when you're used to living at like 8-9
right,
and you slow it down, it's like whoa.
Yeah,
but it is good. It's like
I could see myself at some point wanting to live at a chiller, but not right now, because I'm kind of at the point where I'm trying to build.
I've been talking about that too with Amanda too, same thing. But like who knows what actually is gonna happen, or you know what it is. Ideally, just be here for the summer would be good, and just anywhere else in the winter.
Right.
But
yeah, just bi-coastal.
Yeah, that'd be the best.
Oof, that's the dream.
All right, let's make billions, and then we'll do that. All right?
Let's do it. All
right, cool. All
right,
word.
Cool. All right.
Anything else on
cool.
your
cool, yeah, well, I wanted to shout out, there's a couple of things regarding people who are in our community doing music.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so people around town, anyone who knows Anthony Marchione and Matt Capacetti of Fish Guys and Philadelphia.
Super
you know,
Shredders.
Formerly of
Super Shredders.
Skating on Valo, Super Shredders, Super Killers. Some rippers from Philadelphia. They're in a band called The Mysteries. Mm-hmm. And they're currently on a tour going through the Northeast.
That's it.
If you're in Washington, D.C. tonight, anyone in D.C. tonight, they're playing a show at The Electric Maid. Pretty much now. So if you're listening to this right now and you're in D.C. and you want to see Anthony Marchione and Matt Capacetti and their band The Mysteries, go down to The Electric Maid and check them out. August 4th, they're going to be playing in Brooklyn, New York. So anyone from New York who's tuning in, you can go see their band playing at New Island Entertainment for an afternoon show at 3 p.m. Nothing like an afternoon show.
Nothing
a little
like it.
Catch a little buzz at noon.
A little day drinking.
Go watch a little rock and roll at 3. You know?
I love hearing like the homies like
go
succeeding
to
in other shit. Yeah,
yeah,
like
it's
so sick, because like I never got to see his band. Like every time I played in New York, I'm always fucking doing like a wedding
it's
that
good,
night
man.
Or whatever it is. But like I can know how he fucking skates.
They're a good
and
band.
Like to like see him play guitar like that too. Like
dude,
I just know that's how he brings it to the table. You know,
I went there with Corey. Me and Corey went to go see him. Mm-hmm. He did a show at
Did you see him in New York?
Somewhere in Brooklyn.
Yeah. Oh, that was when Corey was here?
Yeah, it was last year. Somewhere in Brooklyn. I don't remember the spot. I think it's a spot on North 5th. I can't remember the name of it. But anyways, he's an incredible frontman, an incredible guitar player.
Does he sing or no?
He sings. Oh, okay. He's amazing. Damn. Dude, he's amazing. Like, he's a really sick
guy. I got to have him serenade me next time.
So anyone who's
skate.
In D.C. tonight or in Brooklyn, New York on the 4th, which is Saturday, check them out. New Island Entertainment, 3 p.m. And also anyone in Philly or Bethlehem, Pennsylvania, August 5th at Music Fest, 8:30 p.m. Mm-hmm. The Mysteries. So do you like surf rock? Anything like that?
I dig it. I don't like... It's not like my music of choice, whatever. But
it's not
I
your
dig
bag?
It. No, but I would definitely like to see... Live music is live music. It's live usually... Music. As long as it's not like country or something like that, I don't mind he's hearing it, you know.
You're not tolerant to country at all?
It's got to take a lot to get me to go to like a country show. Why? You like country music?
I mean, dude, I think there's something in everything that's good, you know?
I mean, as a drummer, I like watching like drummers just do different genres or whatever it is that they do. And I could watch, if I go to like a country show, I'm going to just watch the drummer. Like, that's it. Like, I'm not really going to be like,
well, that's what I'm going to do like every show.
I'm
anyway,
not
going to
buy
almost
a cowboy hat and like whatever. Yeah.
I feel like I'm doing that at every show regardless.
Yeah.
So it's,
I do that too.
But what about Lana Del Rey? You don't like that?
I mean,
little, what
I,
about Hank
what,
Williams?
What I go
do
to
like
see
Hank Williams,
Hank, like you're just, there's shit that like, yeah, like I'll listen to it, whatever, but I'm not like, I'm not going to put them on like my playlist or whatever.
Fair enough.
Yeah.
But yeah, I think it's, yeah, Corey and I saw him last year and it was really good. So I,
you
so
seen
I think,
them on Saturday?
You know,
are you working?
I am working, but I think I might have some downtime around 3 p.m. Mm-hmm. And if I am working in Brooklyn, I am certainly going to pop in and see them for sure.
Yeah. Oh yeah. Cause it's like an afternoon show.
Yeah. So 3 p.m. So it might be a little slow. I might be able to catch them, but it's and then yeah. August 5th in Bethlehem, Pennsylvania.
Mm-hmm.
Two other things in music I wanted to bring up. Bashi Pope. August
of the Pope Off.
Of the Bashi Pope Skate Off. The same Bashi. Mm. Not a different one.
Okay,
same guy.
Bashi.
Yeah. August 24th, 2018. Black Mexico coming out. I heard some of these songs on his SoundCloud. If you want to listen to it, go to soundcloud.com. Type in Bashi Pope. B-O-S-C-H-I Pope. And...
He also posts stuff on his Instagram,
like
the videos and stuff like that. He's got a lot of videos going on.
Dude, that song, I really like that song, Bag. It's like
I don't know which one is which. I definitely heard them all. I just don't know which one is which. How's it go?
It's like the most tough guy song, dude.
How's it go?
Like, I don't know, because like the beat's like the thing that I like the most.
Yeah, yeah.
But that song, Bag, goes seriously hard. So check that out. At Bashi Pope on Instagram. Hashtag Silk City, Silky Balboa.
Oh, yeah, Silk City.
Yeah, shout out to Silk City. And also Matthew Ledeau.
Oh, yeah, that was sick.
Matthew
Ledeau
just came out with a new album himself. I didn't even know he did music.
Yeah, me neither.
Yeah, I knew he did, like, parkour.
Everything else.
I knew he was in 300.
Matt Ledeau of skating and 300.
I knew all that.
Yeah.
But I didn't know he did music.
Yeah, me neither.
So he just dropped an album. It's streaming. Yeah, I saw a post on his Facebook, and it's streaming on...
We were listening to it a little before the show.
Yep.
That was pretty good. I don't know what
streaming
he's,
on Bandcamp.
If he's doing them all or he's like just a singer or whatever it is. It sounds legit though. Legit as fuck.
Yeah, I think he's like Rob and Miguel. He's in that category where just like he's just open and he's so good at all.
He's like
he does.
The nicest person ever, also
he,
like one of those. Like
really
you met him before,
is.
He's like the nicest guy ever. Super open, super chill. I wish he skated more. I loved watching him skate.
Man, his sections from back in the day.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like,
oh my God.
Come on, Matt. Let's get you on some skates again. I know you're probably got like an actual career and stuff like that, but you still skate once in a while.
I'm sure if he put his skates on, he would be magnificent.
Of course. I don't know. Is he still doing like parkour stuff like that? Do you know anything?
I know he stays in shape.
He doesn't like post that much on social media.
Yeah.
Right? Because I'm like friends with him. I don't really see much of it.
You know, I haven't been too in social media lately, so I don't know.
Yeah.
I've been kind of slacking.
Yeah.
But by choice. It was conscious effort.
Yeah. But you're back though, right?
Kind of. In a more healthy way.
Yeah. That's what I was saying. You got to be back in like a more healthy way. It's like social media. People talk shit on social media all the time, but it's not like, it's how you use it.
Yeah.
Which is how shitty or good it is.
It's how you use it. Exactly.
It's a tool. It's how you use it. You know?
It's a tool.
It is.
But that Matthew Ledeau album, it's called... An Old Good News. Mm-hmm. An Old Good News. And he's selling it. The whole album, $12 on Bandcamp. So it's a very unique style of... is that for the cameras?
Yeah, it's for the cameras.
Okay. So Austin's going to...
I got to reset the cameras again.
Reset the cameras one more time. But it's a very like unique style of music, very deep, you know, like in-depth singing, very drum-oriented, a lot of like good guitar sounds in there, and I just say it's like a very nice sounding music. So if you're into that kind of stuff, check it out because it's
definitely feel-good music.
Yeah, I think you'd refer to it as like a feel-good music. So it's really good. It's really cool. So yeah, check out those three things in music. The Mysteries touring on tour this weekend, Bashi Pope, Black Mexico, August 24th, and Matthew Ledoux, and Old Good News. And
people have noticed that we're matching, by the way.
Did they notice that?
Yeah. People have been shouting us out the whole time. It was not on purpose. I literally noticed like 5 minutes before you were doing some pull-ups, and I was like, oh shit, we're rocking the same gear. Almost the same gear.
Yeah, but Austin could have done something about it because we're at his house.
But I didn't.
But he didn't.
It's my uniform now. It's our uniform.
His shirt's cool. It says Staten.
There you go. That's where we're at right now.
But other than that, that's our show for the day. It's episode one. I think right now we're going to open it up to questions.
Does anybody have any questions? We have a lot of comments, but not a lot of questions.
If anyone has any questions, feel free to ask now.
Why is Murda laughing at us? Why are you crying, Mike? Damn, we got to get a Murda show going.
I've noticed if there's anything I learned, that you can't base your life around what Murda thinks. I learned that a long time ago.
What's good with Billy's band? You still jamming? Well, you touched on that before. You want to?
No, I mean, the band that we were in, Roast, it broke up. Just got to the point where I guess it gets difficult to be in a band with more people than yourself, you know, when you're like in a band with multiple people, it's like different attitudes, and that's why most bands break up. It's a hard thing to sustain. So it was just a clash.
Especially when you're like adults and stuff.
Right, exactly.
Got their own shit going.
Yeah, everyone's changing, doing different things, but it was just a clash in personalities. But John Bellino still has his band going on. It's called Death Chant. It's a separate project in LA, and Connor and John formerly of Roast have a band called Muggy going on. So check that out. And no, but I'm still playing drums. I always play drums. Me and Austin have we used to have like a weekly powwow where we practiced and played together. But right now I've been working a lot, but I intend to start another project soon because playing music is fun.
Definitely. That's like something you could do forever. Skating you could do for a long time, but music you could do forever.
A bit longer. Yeah. Well, not forever.
Video's back?
As long as you live.
All right, we're back on video. I don't know what happened there, but we're back.
All right, well, we're back on video.
Can we expect another Fish Hammer edit in the future, or are we taking it easy? You taking it easy?
I don't know. I go back and forth. Like, sometimes I see...
I didn't expect you to do some of the shit that you did, even for this last edit. Like, you were hitting drop rails. That last trick was pretty gnarly, too.
Yeah, I mean...
That's just how you do it, though. Can you not, like,
I mean,
do that?
Sometimes I just see spots that, like, make me stoked. Like, we saw a gap to rail the other day
Yeah,
in that I was like, I just want to do that. Like, you know, so like, yeah, you know.
It just lives with you, I guess. Like, you want to do certain... Like, you just can't help. That's just how you skate. That's how you are, you know? It's like...
I can say this. I think that I'll be skating more now that I'm living closer to Austin.
And we're skating more just in general anyway.
So I think because of that, you know, I think we'll be putting out a lot more stuff in the future for sure.
Yeah, I think so too. We should definitely work on more street stuff.
And especially through not only...
We should do one street day a week, one park day a week.
See? You see,
you like
Austin?
That? You like
see?
That?
This is where things get done.
All right, we're good. We're good on that.
Good.
All right, so Carter LeBlanc says, you both agree living in New York is your favorite right now. What, if any, other states are your favorite places to skate? Would Cali be the cliche?
In the United States?
States.
Okay. Well, one of my favorite states. Let's see. Arizona is incredible.
Yeah. I definitely had a lot of good time skating in Arizona. You haven't been there forever, right? You just skated that one. Oh, it's always sunny in whatever. Was it Philadelphia?
Yeah.
What was it called?
It's always sunny in Arizona.
Oh, yeah.
That was the last time I was there, but that place is incredible. And I think Massachusetts, I like.
Well, we had a lot of good time skating there. I mean, you did too, especially, but I definitely have a good time skating there also.
Yeah. And all of California, of course.
Yeah, Ola Cali is always good. I'm trying to think. Yeah, I guess Arizona used to be like one of my favorites too. I haven't been there in a long time to skate.
North
like
Carolina too, and Atlanta too is.
Dude. Atlanta, yeah. I haven't been in Atlanta in a long time, but I remember skating spots out there.
Dude, Bell South is still like.
Which one is that?
Which
spot
is that? The number one skate spot of all time.
Which one is that?
It's just.
Is that where the Kink Down Ledge is?
No, it's like the Tilted Wall Rides.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Like I got you. I never skated that spot.
Oof.
Never skated
it's
that.
It's like the best.
Yeah. I never seen any
what
clips
about
of
you
there.
What are your. Is
I don't know. I had fun in Arizona too. LA is good too. There's like a lot of driving around and stuff though. Kind of kills my vibe sitting in traffic from spot to spot.
Yeah.
I don't know. I always have fun like skating Connecticut. We're like the one time a year we skate Connecticut with like Brendan and stuff. Like there's a lot of hidden gems out there. People don't really skate in Connecticut. Like, or like not don't skate, but like you don't really see that much footage or photos or whatever it is from Connecticut. So it's always cool. Like it's under wraps. And last edit I made, I skate a lot of Connecticut spots in there and there's a lot of shit that I didn't expect
that
to see out there. It was cool.
See, yeah.
Yeah, it's really cool
for
that.
Gems.
Yeah, yeah, gems. Other than that, I haven't really traveled in the States to skate a lot recently. I want to skate. I've been wanting to skate with, like, the Sacramento dudes, like Sean Keane and Casey Bergazzi and shit like that. Like, when I see all this shit on Instagram, I'm like, I want to be
so
a part of
it.
Yeah, it's just mad fun.
Yeah,
and that's, like, what like
so
we're doing this shit for. Like, you know, it's just all about fun. And, like, every time I see them, I'm like, fuck, I want to go. And I try to go over the winter, but they're like, nah, weather's not good. Maybe before it gets cold again, get a session going over there.
Yeah.
I want to go out there.
That'd
be fun.
I'd love to, man. I'd love to.
Joey says, episode two, I want to see consistency. Spit that.
Consistency. For those who don't know, consistency is my rap name. And we're saying that's my rap name because, you know, I'm not so good. I'm not
so
bad.
You're not on a label yet.
I'm not really great, but I'm just consistent. I'm
there
like kind of right in the middle.
And that's all that matters when it comes down to
so.
It.
So even though I don't rap at all, like I don't at all, but I mean, if I were to rap, my rap name would be consistency.
Yeah, there you go.
Because I'm just, you know, I'm right.
I haven't thought of my rap
I'm
name
right
yet.
Right in the middle. I'm not that good.
Matthew Rice says, anti or flat and why?
Oh, I skate anti just because I've been doing it forever. I mean, like,
you skate Tri-Rocker by default now, actually. Because you still haven't fixed it. I got you a wheel tonight before
okay,
we go.
Cool. I broke a mini wheel. But no, I skate anti because I've been doing it since, like, 95. So
did
just,
you ever ride freestyle? No, right? Not really.
Yeah, I did like when the murder block first came out. And then I learned,
like
after a year, that wasn't the way.
Yeah.
But
no offense.
No, yeah. I just realized that when I, like, hit a stair like that, I just, like, slid down it.
It just changed, like, my whole style of skating when I rode freestyle.
Not the way for me, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, some people kill it, but that wasn't my style either. I ride flat now. I've been riding flat again for a few years, and I love it. I ride flat with the small wheels. I got, like, 55s, the Abdio Eulogy wheels.
That's the move, I think.
That's my theory, too, and I still agree with it, because I still see people skating flat with, like, whatever the big wheels are, like 60 plus, 65, 70, whatever it is. And they ride flat and like, oh, it's the best. I love it. And they kind of like have like a learning curve to it, I guess, because you still get wheel bite and your top sides are weird. But people almost always go back to either anti or just a regular street setup. You know what it is?
Yeah.
And I've been riding flat on the 55s. And it's been perfect for me. I don't get stuck ever. I like almost had no transition between anti and flat because with the create frames, I had enough space anyway. I almost never get stuck. It's just like, I think it's perfect.
Yeah.
I think if you're going to skate like
I could see
street,
myself doing that.
Way. Yeah.
I could see myself doing that.
You should give it a shot. It's
I
cool.
might give that a shot.
Yeah.
But I wouldn't do anything higher than 55.
No, me neither. I do 55.
I'm just at the age where I don't want to get stuck.
Yeah, getting stuck sucks.
That's it.
Yeah.
I just want to make sure I'm going to go.
I almost never get stuck.
That's
which
number
is,
one.
That's good.
Yeah. Do we have anything else?
Let me see.
We should probably take like two or three more if we have it. If we don't, we should be like, we love you guys.
Alex Cariana says, "Who do you?" I don't know. That's a weird one. Who do you guys consider pro who never got a pro skate besides Austin? Not that it included me, but do you think there's anybody who should have gotten a pro skate that hasn't gotten a pro skate?
Yeah, I totally think you should have. Like,
no,
I
definitely not should have.
I also think Franco should have been pro.
Franco definitely had, like, he's been so good for so long.
Yeah, I totally think Franco should have been.
Who's
pro.
Not like our boy, so it doesn't sound like we're fucking I totally patting each other on the back. Anybody?
Yeah, I totally think people like Casey Bergazzi should have been pro.
I always like.
Well, I think Bergazzi was am for Rosies.
Yeah, I always wanted a Walt Austin pro skate. I don't think he ever got a pro skate.
I think he did.
I think he got a bullshit pro skate. It was
like a boot only, right?
It was like a boot only that was just like a black boot, and they didn't say his name on it or anything. It was just a black boot, and it said like, this was his skate, and it was sold only by like Roller Warehouse or something.
Same thing happened with Dustin Hollerin. I feel
he did the same thing too.
I feel like he should have too.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, there's a bunch of good people that totally didn't have the opportunity to get a pro skate.
Which, yeah.
But yeah, I mean, I always thought like, yeah, Bagazzi was really sick. And
yeah, what was he like, Am Ferocis at the time?
Yeah, he was Am. And then I think after that, he didn't have a boot sponsor. But yeah, that I really liked, even though he was kind of like, I guess he was more of an Am kind of skater. I really like Mike Martino, like mm-hmm. his skating.
Yeah, yeah.
And
there's probably a few more in there. I just can't think of them right now.
Yeah, I just can't think of
them right now. Walt was always like a favorite of mine, and he used to fuck shit up, and he had like a style in skating. The style is like no other.
Yeah.
It's still to this day, no one skated like him. And
no,
he should have gotten a pro skate. And
his feet were magnets to the floor.
Yeah, and another guy with back problems.
Suction cups.
It's like pretty obvious why he had back problems. Yeah, that makes sense.
You think those physics would have helped him though?
It probably just prolonged the inevitable.
Yeah,
that's what it was.
Yeah.
Shooter says, "Would love to skate with you guys soon. Me and Majette have been knocking some rust off." Shooter, you gotta finish your mini ramp.
Let's do it.
Oh, dude. I want a build day too. I want to go like and help build like for a day at his place and jump in the pool and stuff, barbecue.
I could totally help build or show up when it's built, whatever. It doesn't matter.
I could definitely like work my ass off hard in the heat, or I could just show up.
I could show up when it's made and we could barbecue, or I could help build.
Both work.
We could do both.
I wouldn't mind like a nice hang build day. I haven't built a ramp in like 18 years or something.
I love
like
hanging.
That.
I love as long as it's barbecue. I'm cool.
Yeah. Well, he's got a grill. He's got a sick pool, too. Majette said he's ready.
Also, if he doesn't have a grill, we could buy one for $20.
He definitely has a grill.
Okay, good.
Have you ever been to his house? He has a grill.
I've not been to his house.
Well, so he has a house big enough for a mini ramp, so.
Oh,
you
good.
Know, good. If he's getting a mini ramp, he could afford a $20 grill.
Okay, good. Yeah, so we'll definitely have to do that, Jimmy. What do we got? One more question? Or?
Rap name is Pizza. Yeah, we'll get like one or two more. Let me see what I'm scrolling through everything. I think J-Ro's watching.
Is he?
Someone's tagging him in it.
Shout out to J-Ro. Jeremy Stevenson.
We need J-Ro back in the
my
game.
My old roommate.
Hmm.
A true photographer, veteran in skating, brought the light of a lot of great shots to the world.
That's
a lot of iconic images.
Watching like the Vibralux raw clips that have been put up, like J-Ro's in every shot because like shooting photos of Alex or whatever.
Dude,
it is
he was
and he's like
during
every shot, and I'm like, damn, J-Ro, yo, J-Ro. And I tell you, he hit me up the other day and I was like, damn, I haven't spoken to you in forever,
dude. The most iconic shots, like him, you know, just Darren Forth,
Bernard Rigondolo. I'm sorry, I've sucked with reading names and shit. Any Asia tour plans? Philippines?
No.
I would love to go to I know there's like a little skate scene in the Philippines and shit. Yeah. I don't think I have any plans to go out there. I know I want to go to like Singapore.
I haven't left the country in like 4 years, so this is a question for Austin.
I know I want to go to Singapore and like Myanmar and stuff like that. So, but I don't know. We don't really have any plans for the Philippines yet, unfortunately. Unless something pops off over there and we have a reason to go.
Unless Franco comes back and he's like, guys, we got to go to the Philippines.
Franco hasn't even been to the Philippines in forever.
Since he was five.
Yeah, since he was five.
He's been there.
Doesn't even count. Yeah, since he was five. Pacho S. I don't know how to say that. What do you think about blading becoming an Olympic event and have country teams? Isn't skateboarding in the Olympics next?
2020.
2020?
Mm-hmm.
I saw like some skateboarders talking. They were like, oh, you guys like training for the Olympics, whatever? And they're like, yeah, like fuck it, why not, you know? Like I feel like that's how it would be for us too. Like I feel like you would see a lot of people come out of retirement if blading didn't make it into the Olympics.
Yeah,
I don't know if there would be teams. Is that how it would? I guess you would have to just represent. It wouldn't be teams, you just represent your country.
Well, yeah, it'd be the American team, the Italian team, the like the Chinese team, you know?
Yeah,
like French, you know?
Yeah.
But I mean,
would you like make an effort for that?
Yeah, well, no. I mean, personally, no. But I think it's good.
No, you wouldn't.
Would I make an effort to be in it?
Yeah.
No.
Why?
I'm not.
The Olympics, yo.
Any longer.
The Olympics.
I'm no longer pro.
It doesn't matter. To say that you like compete in the Olympics and that'd be fucking sick.
I mean, if I could,
and you easily could.
I would imagine if blading did get into the Olympics, that they would be a higher caliber of skater, like kind of what Joe Atkinson, CJ, and all these guys.
Yeah, I mean, all those guys would fucking destroy it anyway.
I would assume that, but so I likely wouldn't be in it. But would I, if they said, "Hey, Billy, we got an extra spot for a guy like you," I'd say, "Sure."
Yeah,
I would happily join.
So you would only do it if they like open the invitation to you.
Well, it just wouldn't be my primary focus. As far as if I think it's cool or not, I do, because like it's just like another thing, like the, you know, the big wheels, like the Red Bull ice hockey thing. It just like adds more layers to the story to the culture, you know. So it just opens more doors for people who want to be involved.
Yeah,
you know,
a huge audience too.
Yeah, to get to see it. Exactly. I would assume like a lot of people that were involved in like the Core Street stuff, like as Mike Torres like to say, Core Street. Like, I know a lot of them probably wouldn't be the people who would be in the Olympics, because likely it would be right Vert.
Yeah, of course.
And then some sort of,
or just like probably six, maybe some course, sort of, like a so maybe a mega maybe ramp so. Or something like
yeah,
that.
Yeah, I could see like, you know, Joe Atkinson and CJ and these guys doing incredible. I'm like, you the French guys, you know, Anthony Pottier as well, and all those guys. And yeah, maybe Yasutoko's if they can. Well, the Vert for sure.
Yeah. I mean, they fuck the street. Yeah, I don't know if they skate like they park contests.
Don't compete in them.
They would probably win them though. I seen Takeshi skate some park lines and they blew my mind.
Yeah.
And not only because I'm a Takeshi fan, but just like in general, like they were like, if anyone saw that, like, holy shit, I didn't know he was capable of doing that stuff. Like, I don't know.
I'd like to see that, to be honest.
I'm curious though how skateboarding, like the industry itself, what the spike is going to be like once the 2020 Olympics hit. Like, is it going to be fucking huge? Is it going to stay the same? I'm curious if that like is a huge jump for the industry.
Yeah. You know, I'd imagine it just does that. Just adds more layers.
It's already so popular already, but like it could just open up a whole new thing. I don't know.
Yeah, but with the skateboarding industry, what they're really good at is, cross marketing promotion.
Yeah.
You know, they've always been good at that, and because they got their hands in so many things that are other things that are cool, like that.
Like Nike.
I'm pretty sure they've
stuff.
Ensured their existence for a long time.
No, definitely.
But when they open that, take that extra step and like go into the Olympics, then that's massive. Yeah. Like, you know, and that's good. You know, I ultimately seeing that as something that is good for everyone.
Yeah.
You
know, so. It definitely is. I'm not like mad that skateboarding's in the Olympics.
No, how could you be?
It's good for them.
How could you be? But like,
I would be mad if scooters got in the Olympics before.
If they got him before us, that
which
would be,
could happen. Who knows?
It could happen. But I see that being less likely, because you have to.
I think so too.
Like you said, consistency. Like, it's like skateboarding's been consistent for a long time.
Yeah.
Like, you know, blading had a time when it was really big, and I think they even talked about it being in the Olympics in the late 90s.
I'm sure like the board of Olympic people like discuss these things. So you can't just be a new sport that's been around for a few years and just jump on there.
Yeah.
Matias Alejandro Sasso says, what's your take on the future of rollerblading for 2019?
Do you want to take this one?
You do it while I find the next question.
Okay, and then that one will be the last one?
It's only been an hour 11. We could do a couple more.
Do a few more.
Yeah, we'll do a few more.
Cool. So...
Wait, got something to do tonight?
No. I just didn't, like, you know... I just didn't know how long we were going to... It doesn't matter, though. I'm not in no rush. But,
No, we still got, like, an hour 11. We could do, like, a few more.
Cool.
Like, 10 more minutes or so.
Cool. Okay, so the future of rollerblading in 2019. How do I see it?
Anything in particular?
You know... It's still really good. Like, it's really whatever anyone makes it. Like, you know, I've been really entertained by a lot of stuff this year. I think it's bad if you kind of see it go into a lull and you see something that's not entertaining. Like, I don't know.
I don't think it'll ever get to that point, at least for us, anyway.
It could. It could.
There's always going to be somebody out there, like, fucking shit up or whatever.
They're, hopefully.
Yeah.
Like, but
hopefully.
But, I mean, like, you know, seeing Joe Atkinson this year, I think, has been, like, really inspirational. Like, you know, like... That even that Instagram clip and just everything he does is just like so, like when you have a person that has that kind of energy that they just like put into like that in front of everyone, you know, it's contagious. And so I think those kind of people are the key people that get people excited about it and get people wanting to do it. And
especially with the traveling, he's like all over the place now too, which also helps. Also.
It's just infecting people. So if like, you know, CJ's the same way, you know, Alex has been consistently doing that forever, you know, just always like, trying to keep his eye open to new things. And obviously he's like very athletically capable. So it's like that, the combination of like mind and skating, but it's just going to, I think it's just going to like in the people who are the most, inspirational people, like are the people who like are the most motivational people to motivate others, and it's going to live on. You know, I think it's going to be what it's been for a while, just people pushing on, making skating live on and being inspired, you know, as it goes. And
on that note, there's a question here from Austin Paz. Well, saying what you just said, is like Joe Atkinson like one of your favorite people to watch skating right now?
Probably right now, yeah.
Yeah, like the...
No, I don't have like the...
Yeah, it's hard to get like...
I don't do that.
The person.
I don't have like, that's my favorite skater.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
I'm an adult. Like,
but he's up there, I guess.
If I was like...
So who else besides Joe Atkinson?
Yeah, like, you know, I love Sean Keane.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
Sean Keane is one of my favorites.
I forgot about him, too. Like, I forgot about mentioning him in, like, that level, which he definitely deserves to be.
Everyone in, like, the Spain crew, like, Shredweiser guys, you know, I like Mark Moreno and, you know, Nick Lomax is crushing it, right?
Like, yeah. Skating every day.
Skating so good.
Yeah.
Like, so, like, all those guys, you know, like, there's something I could see like every day that gets me stoked. But yeah, I mean, cool. Totally Joe is one of my favorites. I don't have
that's why you got to watch the Burma video and Formosa too, because he's in both of those as well.
I do.
We'll watch it before next week's thing and we'll discuss.
Okay, we'll talk about it. You know, we'll do a video review too. And yeah, guys, by the way, everyone who's participating in the questions, thank you for tuning into the show.
Yeah.
Again, if you're just tuning in, follow us on Instagram at Jump Street Podcast. Facebook.com/JumpStreetPodcast, as well as
YouTube and SoundCloud. All the links are below. They're not like real links, whatever. YouTube, follow us on YouTube. We're going to have the edited version of this up tomorrow or the next day, hopefully. And if you have other angles and stuff like that, it's going to look nice. Trust us.
And any suggestions that you guys may have, like, you know,
this is a learning process for us.
We're talking about, you know, maybe doing video reviews, edit reviews.
Something like that.
Edit breakdowns, section breakdowns, things like this. You have any ideas that you think would be cool for a show like this? Just please send them in. We'll take it into account. And like I said, this is going to be a show we intend to have guests, some of your favorite people, some of your favorite skaters, company owners, and just humans in general. So I hope you guys tune in. And
it's been fun. I think it was a good pilot. It's our pilot episode.
I think this was a good pilot. Are we going to cut it here? Do you want to ask any more questions?
I'm trying to see if there's anything like there are like a lot of questions. Like I can't even catch up with it now.
Okay.
So Eric Garcia says, do you like to skate with your hair tied or untied?
You know, I'll be honest, and this is going to sound a little weird, but when I'm just like skating, having fun, right? I have to tie it up because it's so long.
Yeah.
You know, or else it gets in my face. You go fakie, it's in your face.
Mm-hmm.
So I tie it up. But when that camera comes out for a clip, right?
It changes everything.
Now, this is going to sound funny, right? Because I'm just... But it's true. I'm like, oh, you know what? I'll take it down for the clip.
Uh-huh.
You know what I mean? So, because...
It's all about that image.
It's not only for it to, like, look cooler, but it's like when it's tied up, it looks so uncool because my hair is, like, puffed out everywhere.
What do you do? You do the bun? Like, I don't even notice, like, what you do.
Well, I do the twist.
So it's like a bun?
Yeah, like I put in a thing, I twist it. Okay. It's like a little kind
of
bun.
I've never been a hair tie guy. Even when, like, my hair's too short now, but when it was longer, I never tied it up. I used to wear a hat, actually, a lot.
But it gets tough when it gets long for skating.
Yeah.
So I had it tied, but it comes out like little bits here and there, and I just look like a homeless person. So it's like a double reason to take it down for the clip. So I, like, one, can look cooler, two, don't look like a homeless person, and then it's like the combination. But yeah, that's, I don't know, probably, I might cut it soon. Like every time I've grown it this long, I've like donated, like I cut off.
Like, oh yeah, you did. I remember like
I've
last
done
time
it twice.
You did.
Like, cut off like a foot of it. I sent it to like Locks a Love.
Yeah.
I'm thinking about doing it again.
Yeah.
But yeah,
it's a good thing to do.
It's getting annoying.
Billy Clark says Facebook live skate session with trick call outs. We could do it with like Instagram. Maybe not.
Maybe we'll experiment with that at the BPSO.
Yeah, we could do that too.
Yeah.
Maybe we'll get that. It's more of an Instagram thing because we'll have like, it's easy to put like a phone live on that than like a whole setup or whatever it may be.
We can totally incorporate skating in it, but the idea and the purpose of this is to kind of have like a long conversation format, interview style, interactive with, you know, guests and stuff. But yeah, sure, we could, you know, do, everything's going to evolve in the future for sure.
Of course. Yeah. This is still a learning curve for us.
Right.
I think that's it for now. Maybe we'll call it at that.
Well, that's good because I don't have any more water in my cup.
You finished your whole smart water?
I mean, it wasn't that much.
Mine's done.
Well, thank you for tuning into episode 1 of Jump Street.
It was great. Again, what's our next episode?
Wednesday.
We're going to do next Wednesday at 8?
8 p.m.
8 p.m. next Wednesday. We also might experiment with like different times and stuff. later down the line, probably after the Bashi Pope skate-off thing, because we have a lot going on during that time. But expect a lot of episodes with a lot of people visiting from out of state then. And we will be live again next Wednesday. Be sure to follow us still again on Instagram, Facebook, where we will be live from now on. So go like our Facebook page so you can tune in for next time. Share this with everybody. Also check out our YouTube and our Patreon down there. SoundCloud will be out there. Give us a day or two for the edited versions to be out. And be sure to share.
Yeah,
thanks everybody
also,
for the feedback.
If you joined us late and you caught us halfway through the episode, if you jumped in at the last minute, if you're just joining us now, we're going to have this episode up. It should be on our YouTube channel by tomorrow. If not, it'll be up the following day. So be sure to subscribe and like our YouTube channel as well.
Yep.
Well, thank you very much for joining us. It was a lovely experience. Austin, great show.
Good job.
Thanks for joining us, guys.
All right. Good night, everyone.
See you next week.